अब आपको एक बार फिर अवारी होटल में ले चलते हैं, जहां पे कानून दान आसमा जहांगीर की याद में ताजीती रेफरेंस जारी है।
Availability of the fundamental rights, and kindly look at the world around, then in which countries the fundamental rights and the human rights are primordially taken as sacred and are enforced, and the countries where there is none. So it is primarily the foundational and the basic feature of our constitution, which besides the Islamic provision of our constitution, I rate that the democracy is the basic structure of the constitution. And dependent upon the democracy are the fundamental rights of the people of this country for which Asma Jahangir throughout has been striving. Without any consideration, she has a passion for that. I think this was genetically inbuilt, instilled in Asma Jahangir, that she had to help somebody who was in pain, somebody who was in misery, particularly starting on from the ladies' rights to protection, maintenance, blah, 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 blah. But ultimately, she turned out to be one of the finest human rights activists. The interpretation of law made by her in this context and some of the cases argued before my humble bench, I tell you, amazingly high quality. And this all, I believe, was dependent upon the knowledge, but the passion behind it was amazing. The passion and the force behind it was unmatchable. Asma was known to me since 1980. We are contemporaries. She must be about 2 years older to me. And I met him in the court. And why did we develop this relationship of brother and sister? She was vomiting in the court. And not too well. I think Ramize was coming to the world that time. And I took her to the hospital. There was a hospital, Umar Hospital, where I took him. And I do recall not only other physicians, but the surgeon, Dr. S.M. Sa, was also present. He did look her, but she was having pain in the abdomen and vomiting. Maybe it was something to do with a food poisoning. But that is the day I called her Appa. And the first question she asked me, "Tum mere to Eddie ho, ye tu maine Appa kehna shuru kar diya." So I told her that who I respect out the ladies, I call them an APA. I call you, Ramize, also as an APA. This because is the gesture of respect for my daughter, the respect for whom I really love and respect. Then my second interaction with her was, we have been meeting in the courts in so many cases. The second interaction was when she came to my office and said, "Oh, mere ko nahi hai samajh aandi." Well, what happened? What's the issue? Oh, ye koi Lahore grammar walon ka koi issue hai that is pertaining to a rent case. The case is fixed for such and such judge. What a difficult judge hai, gali nahi sunda. So I want you to do that case. Since that day, I have been the retainer of the Lahore grammar school, which she used to be the retainer of that Lahore grammar. She passed on that to me. Then another incident, the closeness which I would like to tell. I believe Tahir Jahangir Sahib is here somewhere. Tahir Sahib, you are there. Tahir Sahib had some company issue. Do you remember? You had a company issue, some company matter. And Asma Apa came to me. Until I was elevated, I think the matter had been on. But I didn't lose your case, sir. That is a respect and honor I think I have for Asma Jahangir. She was an amazing lady, unremarkable. And she, as I've already spoken about, that was a true teacher. Without her, we would not have been able to achieve the criteria, the standards, and the development of our jurisprudence, which we have developed over the period in human rights security. A gentleman from India, who spoke, I don't know his good name, but some lawyer, he said that Pakistan is far ahead of the Indians as far as the human right is concerned. Yes, we are far ahead. Why? Because perhaps there is none like Asma Jahangir, those who could fight for the human right of the people of Pakistan. Sir, she has always been there. She has always shown her love for this country. She has worked so hard for any downtrodden section of the society without any consideration, without any remuneration. And I feel very proud that Asma was my Aapa. I am humbled that she has been my teacher, and also that today, present, what legacy she has left for us. It is the duty imposed upon each of us sitting in this hall, wherever the need be, to come forth and to help the people, those who cannot help themselves and are the oppressed and the marginalized class of this society. Long live Asma Aapa, long live Asma Aapa, long live Asma.
For this inaugural session of Asma Jahangir Conference, indeed it's emotional, as well as we all of us are showing tribute and our love for Asma Jahangir. One of our moderators, she's also one of the very vibrant member of the team. Member Sarfraz is around. She wants to make some announcements. She would be explaining that how the other events are going on and about the social media.
टीम में मेहमान खसूस रहे और उन्होंने आसमा जहांगीर की याद में ताज़ियती रेफरेंस भी दिया। आवारी होटल में तकरीब का इनेकाद किया गया। चीफ जस्टिस के जानिब से कहना था कि हम आसमा जहांगीर को आपा कहकर बुलाया करते थे। आसमा जहांगीर को आपा कहता था, बोली मैं आपसे बड़ी हूँ।